So today we will discuss that is Maxwell's equations inside matter. Maxwell's equations inside matter. Now so far we have learned that is the Maxwell's equations. These are, first equation is the divergence of the electric field is equal to rho by epsilon 0. Rho is the charge density, epsilon 0 is the permittivity of free space, and E is the electric field. Number 2, that is divergence of magnetic field is equal to 0. This implies that there is no magnetic monopoles. And 3, that is Faraday's law, this is curl of the electric field is equal to minus del V del T. That is, this is Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. And 4, we have del cross B, that is the, this is the modified form of Ampere's law, that is del cross B is equal to mu 0 J plus mu 0 epsilon 0 del E del T. So these are the 4 Maxwell's equations. Okay. Now we will see how these 4 Maxwell's equations are modified in case of matter. Now, from the sense of electricity, matter can be classified into 2 groups. One is insulator or dielectrics. These are the bad conductors of electricity, and 2, these are the conductors which are the good conductors of electricity. The metals come in this class where the free electrons are the charge carriers, and also there are ionic conductors where the ions carry the electricity. Now mainly we will concentrate on the dielectric materials. Now in case of dielectrics, there are mainly 2 kinds. From the sense of electricity, there are 2 kinds. In one case of dielectric, the atoms or molecules consisting the dielectric have no permanent electric dipole moment. Permanent electric dipole moment. Now, suppose this is such kind of a dielectric material, and these are the atoms or molecules inside the dielectric. Now, in normal case, these individual atoms or molecules, they do not have permanent electric dipole moment. If I enlarge one atom or molecule, see inside in the center, there is a positively charged nucleus, and outside we have a negatively charged electron cloud. Now what happens? Normally, in this case of dielectrics, the center of the positive charges coincide with the center of the negative charges. So there is no electric dipole moment. But if we apply an external electric field to this atom, what happens? The center of the positive charges is pushed a little bit towards the field direction. So center of the positive charges come here and the center of the negative charges are pulled in this direction. So the center of the negative charges are pulled in the opposite direction to the field, and there occurs, there develops a tiny electric dipole moment inside the atom. So what happens? All the atoms, they inside them, there develops electric dipole moment, and we say that the dielectric is polarized. Dielectric is polarized. Okay. Now, in another case, what happens? The atoms and molecules inside the dielectric, they have permanent electric dipole moment. Permanent electric dipole moment. So, in another case, the atoms or molecules have permanent electric dipole moment. Electric dipole moment inside the atom. Okay, so here we have a space. Now, suppose this is such kind of dielectric material. Now, here these are the constituent atoms or molecules. And we have dipole moment, but they are randomly oriented. Randomly oriented electric dipole moments. So, if we take the vector sum of all these dipole moments, the net dipole moment is 0. The net dipole moment P is equal to 0, and this dielectric is not polarized. But if we apply an electric field, external electric field, what happens? This external electric field applies a torque on these individual dipoles, and these individual dipoles will have a tendency to align in the field direction. But there are, due to temperature, there are thermal motions, and the individual atoms and molecules, they are colliding with each other, that will disturb this alignment, but still there will be a net dipole moment in the direction of the field. In the direction of the field, and in this case, if we take the vector sum of all the individual tiny dipoles, the net dipole moment will be not equal to 0, and we will say that the dielectric is polarized. Now, when this dielectric is polarized, we define a quantity called the polarization vector, which is nothing but the electric dipole moment per unit volume. Electric dipole moment per unit volume. So, we define a quantity capital P. This is the net electric dipole moment. Per unit volume. And this is also called the polarization vector. This is called polarization vector. Okay, Now, in case of polarized dielectrics, in case of polarized dielectrics, there develops bound charges and there develops bound charges one is a volume bound charge volume bound charge density is rho v and in another bound charge is surface bound charge whose density is sigma v. Surface bound charge density that is sigma v. Now this volume bound charge density is related to the polarization vector now this volume bound charge density volume bound charge density rho v is can be shown is equal to minus divergence of p del dot p and the surface bound charge density surface bound charge density sigma b is equal to p dot n cap where n cap is the unit normal vector to the surface of the dielectric. Okay, so we have two kind of bound charges in case of polarized dielectric. Now another case happens if the external electric field changes, if the external electric field changes, then there will be polarization current and polarization current density density Jp is equal to del P del T. So far we have discussed about the electric polarization. Now there may be another phenomenon that is called from the point of view of magnetic field and there occurs magnetization of the material. Now, from the sense of magnetism, there are three kind of materials. One is diamagnet, another is paramagnet. And another, the last one is ferromagnet. Now, in case of diamagnet, this, suppose this is a diamagnet. Now, these are the constituent atoms or molecules. Now, what happens? This constituent atoms and molecules, in case of diamagnet, in normal case, they do not have magnetic permanent magnetic dipole moment. But if we apply magnetic field to this diamagnet, this is suppose a diamagnet. There develops tiny magnetic dipoles in the direction opposite to the applied magnetic field. So, there develops tiny magnetic dipole moment in the direction opposite to the magnetic field. And we can construct a quantity called the magnetic net magnetic dipole moment per unit volume, that is called the magnetization vector. Okay, so this is the case of diamagnet. Now, in case of paramagnet, in case of paramagnets, paramagnets, the constituent atoms and molecules, they have permanent magnetic dipole moment, but they are randomly oriented magnetic dipole moment. And what happens if we apply an external magnetic field? This magnetic field will exert torque on these tiny magnetic dipoles, and these tiny magnetic dipoles will try to align in the field direction. There will be, of course, thermal agitation which will try to disturb this alignment, but still there will be a net dipole moment, magnetic dipole moment of the material. And net dipole moment is not equal to zero. Net magnetic dipole moment is not equal to zero. Now, in this is the second case. Now, in case of ferromagnets, what happens? In case of ferromagnets, we have domains, magnetic domains, in which domains there is, suppose in this domain there is a net magnetic dipole moment. In this domain we have a net magnetic dipole moment, but in this direction, and in this domain the magnetic dipole moment is in this direction. Here in this direction. Now, what happens when we apply external magnetic field? This magnetic dipole moment will try to align themselves in the direction of the field. So, we have a net magnetic dipole moment of the material. Now, in case of all these three kind of magnetic materials, we define a quantity called the magnetization vector. Magnetization vector which we denote as M, this is nothing but M is the net magnetic dipole moment per unit volume. Okay, so M is the magnetization vector. Okay, now in case of this magnetic materials, there develops a current, bound current, in case of this magnetic materials, these magnetic materials, there develops, bound currents. One is volume bound current, and we denote it by the current density vector JB, that is equal to del cross M, that is the curl of the magnetization vector. And another is surface bound current, and this we denote as JB, and this is suppose JS, and that is equal to M cross N cap, where N cap is the unit normal vector to the surface of the magnetic material. Okay, now so we have discussed the two kinds, that is two kinds of phenomena, that is electric polarization and magnetization in case of magnetic materials. Now after discussing all this, we will see how these Maxwell's equations, they are modified by taking into account these volume bound charges and volume bound currents.